Alright, hey guys, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a minute since I uploaded anything, but 2019, we're gonna get back into it. I actually have an ice day today because it is literally not so outside. So my work called me and they were like, don't bother coming in. And I was like, thank you, I'm going to sit here with a cup of hot chocolate, enjoy my day off, be cozy. It's just one of those days. So today I wanted to do something like a little casual, kind of get me back into making videos, things like that. So we are going to be doing a Sephora Play unboxing. This is the box for January. I just got this box like literally a few days ago. So I don't know why their shipping is so slow on this, because I swear I got an email like maybe 3 weeks ago and they were like, your box is shipping. And I'm like, okay, great. And I just got it. Anyway, so this is the Sephora Play box. It is a subscription box. It is $10 a month. I've been subscribing to this box for maybe like a couple years now at least. And I like it just because, you know, you get brands that you know about in it. So let's dive in to the box. So first off, as always, we always get a little pamphlet here. It tells us about the products, and you get this little $50 Beauty Insider point card. So you can take that into any Sephora and get an extra 50 beauty points. I don't live by a Sephora though. So it looks like the theme for this month is, oh, it's beauty scopes. It's like a little horoscope thing. That's really cute. I'm a Leo, so let's see what mine says. Leo, talk about star quality. The brave and determined Leo loves to bask in the spotlight, so it makes sense that you would prioritize glowing skin. Keep a clarifying exfoliator close by to brighten up your complexion. That's cute. I like it. A little lion right there. Okay, so anyway, let's dig in to the contents of this box. So usually we get like 5 products and then they give you a like a little foil packet or a sample or something like that. And they now have been doing their bags in, let me just set that aside there. They've been doing their bags in like little plastic, just reusable Ziploc bags like this, which I really like because I didn't like the drawstring bags before. I never reused them. They were cute sometimes, but like this, I can at least recycle and like feel okay about it, or I can reuse it for something. Like, they're kind of handy. I would say they're more handy than the drawstring bag. So let's get in here. I feel a foil packet in here first, and I hope that is just like our little foil for the month. And this is Way Hair Care shampoo and conditioner. So it looks like this is a repairing shampoo and conditioner. And I now have like a lot of hair, so I don't know if something like this would be quite enough for me, but I have used other Way products and they were nice. So maybe, you know, if I like run out of shampoo or something, I'll give this a try. I like don't really love getting hair stuff, but you know, it is what it is. Foil packet. So let's dig in here some more. I feel a little spray bottle. Look, more hair stuff. And this is the Living Proof Restore Perfecting Spray. And this one, okay, well, I like Living Proof products, first of all. Like, everything that I've tried from them is actually really nice. And I feel like I have, and it smells like all their other stuff. They have a nice, clean, kind of floral scent. This, I'm not sure what this does. Let's see. I feel like all their stuff is kind of like repairing. Oh, okay, so this is basically a leave-in hair conditioner. Spray-in, leave-in hair conditioner. So after you wash your hair, we'll do a little spritz of that. I like hair products like that. Like, that is something that I actually use. I'm not one for like, I don't know, hair masks and like putting too much product in my hair when I'm styling, but I always try to use like a leave-in conditioner after I wash my hair, like a hair oil and like a protecting kind of heat spray. So things like that are actually products that I do use, and I know that I like Living Proof, so I'll give that a try. I mean, it's a pretty small sample, but that'll last me like a few times for sure. By the way, are we loving this vintage Sopranos mug? I say vintage because it's from like the 2000s, like back when Sopranos was like on HBO and super popular. But The Sopranos is literally one of my favorite shows of all time. Okay, so next in here, ooh, I see something in here that I'm like real excited about. So this is the Sunday Riley Good Genes Lactic Acid Treatment, and I have wanted to try this forever, like probably for years. Like, it's been saved in my Sephora list. I have heard nothing but good things about it. It's just supposed to be like a serum. It has lactic acid in it. I love like anything with acid in it, glycolic acid, lactic acid. They just do great things for your skin and just like exfoliate everything, smooth out any fine lines. And I've heard really, really good things about this one. High potency, purified grade lactic acid exfoliates dull, pore clogging skin cells to instantly clarify and reveal smoother, clearer skin. Together with radiance boosting licorice and super concentrated treatment, visibly reduces the look of dark spots and discoloration for clearer, brighter, and more even skin tone. So this one says that you can apply it morning and night. I typically, with any like glycolic acids, lactic acids, I usually kind of do those for the evening time, except for one toner that I use. The Maria Badescu glycolic acid toner is bomb. I use that in the morning, but just be careful with things like glycolic acid or lactic acid, because it does kind of like regenerate your skin cell turnover faster, so it can make your skin a little bit more sensitive, so just make sure you're using an SPF. So Sunday Riley is like a super expensive brand. I like that they kind of put it in the foil packaging, and then it's this little tube here. And you do get 0.17 fluid ounces, which, I mean, yeah, this is a really small sample, but this is also a really expensive product. Like, I think it's over $100 for like a 1 ounce bottle of it. So I'm just excited to try this. Next in here is the Laneige Water Sleeping Mask. I feel like I just got this. I remember I was traveling with it in October, I think. Yeah, because I was visiting a friend and I just grabbed this for a night cream. That's kind of disappointing. But the couple times I used it, I thought it was okay. It's just this little jar of product. I mean, I'll definitely use it again. My skin's super dry right now. And it is like a nighttime sleeping mask, but I felt like it did sink into the skin really well. I like the texture of it too. It's kind of just like a gel texture, so it does feel like really nice and refreshing on the skin and super hydrating. So I mean, I guess if I'm gonna get a repeat product, I'm not really mad about getting this, but I like, if you're gonna do a repeat product, like, come, let's spread it out a little bit. I just got that a few months ago. All right. So I have, oh, I still have a few things. Oh, I only have a couple things left in here. Next we have, oh, this is from Bite Beauty. This is a little matte lip crayon in glace. Bite Beauty is really nice, cruelty free. I feel like a lot of their products are, I don't know if they're vegan, I guess. I was just gonna say they're vegan too, but like, I know that they have really high quality products. Even the packaging of like this little matte lip crayon is really nice. It has a matte finish to it. It's really pretty. So I'm excited to see what this color is like. Ooh, ooh. That's a pretty color. I like that. I would wear that like today. That would look cute with this. It's kind of mauve-y, but it's not too purpley or anything. It's a little bit deeper, almost reddish, but like still mauve-y. I like that. I like that color. That's a good like everyday kind of color. Okay, so lastly, we have in here is a solid beauty blender cleanser. Cute. I've never tried the beauty blender cleanser before. I've heard really, really good things about it. But I always use the Dr. Bronner's, their unscented soap. So this is different because it is a solid cleanser. So I think though, essentially all you do is you just wet your sponge or your brush and like run it in there. And oh, this whole, oh. Okay, so I was like ripping it open. It smells pretty good. I was just like ripping it open and I thought that this was like something that you open, but this whole thing is like, it's like a little bar of soap. That's cute that it's black. I like that. Yeah, but essentially like what you would do is you would take like your beauty sponge and wet it and then like rub it on there and then just cleanse it and wash it. Or you could do the same thing with like, you know, a brush, just wet it and kind of get it on there. So that's kind of cool. I'm kind of annoyed that I just opened that though, because now it's like loose and about. I'm gonna have to like try to, there we go. I'm just gonna attempt to rewrap it. Shoot, that was dumb. Okay. Well, anyway, that was everything that we got in our Sephora play box. I would say overall it was a decent month. I'm really, really excited about this Good Jeans treatment. I am so excited to try that. This was a repeat, so that's kind of, you know, the lip color I think is really pretty. Not excited about the foil packet. I'm excited to give that cleanser a try though, because I've heard such good things about it. So we'll see how that works for me in comparison to like that liquid soap that I always use. Living Proof spray, I can take it or leave it. I'll use it, but I'm not like super jacked about it. And the shampoo and conditioner, I mean, realistically, it's probably just gonna get shoved into a drawer somewhere. But I think overall it was a decent month, I would say. I mean, this little guy right here for the $10 that I spent on the box, like that was worth it for me. So the other things are just kind of little extra items. So thanks so much for watching, guys. I'm hoping to upload a lot more in 2019. I love doing unboxing videos, but I really want to start getting back into doing some makeup tutorials and things like that. So if you would like to see more content from me, if you liked this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and I hope that you all have a beautiful day. Bye!